Welcome to the second video of this series about object-oriented programming and classes in Python. In this video, you're going to learn how to define and use instance, static, and class methods, what the self-parameter is and why it's really important, and also how to use the init special method to initialize instances. So let's talk about instance methods, which are basically functions defined inside the class that you can call on each instance. So to define a method, you can just do something like def introduction, then self, like that, okay? So as you can see, we wrote the self parameter, but why? Basically, an instance method receives automatically as the first argument the instance on which it's called. For that reason, we need to write the self parameter in the method definition. By the way, self is a name used by convention and you should use that, but I just want to point out that another name would work the same. So now we can write what this method does. And in this case, it returns the introduction, something like, I don't know, return an F string, like I am the name and I am age, something like that. So now that we've got a method in place, we can actually create two objects. So person one, person, like that. And then if you want to call a method on an instance, you just do something like person1.introduction, and then as you would do for a function, okay, the two parentheses like that. And this would call this thing here. And then we can do the same thing, but for person2, like this. So person2 and person2. So let's actually print that, otherwise we don't get anything. So print like this, and then print like this. Okay, so if we save it and run it like that, we get an error, name error. Why? Basically, when you call a method and we use name and age, Python looks for those variables locally, meaning it looks for them inside the body of the function. So in this case, if you had like name John here, age 46, they wouldn't throw an error anymore. So if we actually run that, you can see I'm John, I'm 46. But of course, we don't have the variables inside the function. We have the variables here, these two class variables. So that's where the self comes into play. So if you want to access a class variable, we need to use the self. So we need to do something like, let's actually delete those. We need to do something like self and self. And this actually would work. So if we run that, you can see I'm John, I'm 40. So John 40, because we're using self. So do you remember when I told you that when we call a method, the first argument is actually the instance on which the method is called? In this case, when you use something like person1.introduction, under the hood, Python does something like this. It does something like print person introduction, like that, and then person1. So basically, this is the self, person1, and here there would be the same thing, but of course with person2. Okay, like that. So when you call introduction on person one, like in this case, self is the person one, okay, the instance. So if you use self, it's the same as using person one dot name and then person one dot age. Same thing here, person two dot name and person two dot age. Of course, here we're using the class variables, class attributes here, but that would work also if you had like instance variables, okay? That would work the same because we're actually using the instance to access its instance and class attributes. So this is why the self parameter is actually the instance on which the method is called, because this is what Python does under the hood, basically. So let's actually delete all of those things and then keep that. So if you watch the first video of the series, we used person1.name to assign a new value to name and create an instance variable. And we wrote person1.newInstanceVariable to create a new instance variable. So something, we did something like person1.name, Jack, something like that, and then person1.newInstanceVariable. And then we did something like this. But here we're doing this outside the class, okay? You can do that within the class using self. So let's say that we've got another method, change name, and we pass self and then name. So we've got two parameters. Then you do something like self name is equal to name, and then self new instance variable, like that, instance variable. So as you can see here, we are creating these two instance variables, okay, using the self. So this is like we were doing something like person1.name is equal to name, so the name that we pass to change name, and then self.newInstance variable is the same as person1.newInstance variable is equal to instance variable. So you create a new instance variable from within the class, from within the instance, basically. Okay, you're not doing that here, you're doing that inside of the method. So if we call person1.changeName and we pass David like that, Python does actually this under the hood. It does something like person.changeName, it passes the instance on which the method is called, so person1, as the first parameter, so here self, and then the name David like that. So here you've got person1 and here you've got David. We're doing the same thing as doing something like this. We're doing the same thing as doing something like person1.name David. So this is the same as this, but we're doing this from inside the method. We don't need to do that here because we can do that inside of here when we actually call the change name method. So if we print person.name here, you see that we get David, not John, because we actually changed the, we created an instance variable here with this value. Okay, of course, this creates an instance variable, so all the other instances don't have the new instance variable like that. Perfect. Of course, the self works even when you want to call a method inside another method. So here you can do something like self.introduction. So you can call this method inside change name. Of course, here you can do the same thing. So you could call self.change name inside of here if you wanted to. Perfect. So as I said at the end of the previous video, we want to be able to assign a name and age to a person when creating the class instance. We don't want to start out with a class variable name John, age 40, etc., and then change it afterwards as we've done so far. We want to do that directly when we create the instance of the class. Luckily, we have a way of doing this, and we're going to use the init method. So init is a special method like the ones that we're going to look at in the next video of this series. And this method is actually automatically invoked by Python whenever you create a new instance of a class. And we can use it to assign a specific name and age to a person object when we create them. Let's actually remove these two methods. Okay, like that. So instead of writing the name and age here, we can actually delete them like that. And we need to add the init method. So def init, and then here we need to pass the self parameter and then the parameters that we need. So name and age. And then of course, as here we are inside the init method, okay, name and age are locally scoped and only accessible inside this method, which is not that useful because you want to be able to access those variables within other methods, etc., etc. So we need to make them instance variables, and we can do that, of course, with the self. So self name and self age. So basically here we are creating two instance variables, set name with the value of name and set age with the value of age. Then when you want to create a new person with this init function, you can do something like person1 is equal to person like that, John, okay, first parameter here like that, and then 45. Then person2 could be something like David 35, something like that. And of course, if we print person1.name and person2.name, we of course get John and David. So by using the init function, you're sort of defining the default constructor, but using class methods, you can actually create alternative constructors, and that's what we're gonna see now. So let's actually delete that again. Okay, so let's actually add a new variable here, and then let's actually do something like self.city. And also, let's say that we have a class attribute here, language, English, like that, okay, that we're gonna need later. So to create a class method, you can actually use a decorator like this. So you can do something like class method, and then we can define change language. As this is a class method and not an instance method, as the first argument, it receives the class itself and not the instance on which the method is called. And by convention, we use the CLS variable like that, and then the language like this. Perfect. So as we have the class now, we can do whatever with it. We could change class attributes and so on. So let's see, we could do something like language like this. So now if we want to use this method, you can do something like person change language and then Japanese, something like that. Of course, now all instances that we've created will have language Japanese and not English anymore, okay? We can also call it from an instance. So if we had an instance person one, we could do something like person one dot change language, etc., etc. But because something is possible, doesn't mean that you should do it. This could be useful, but not that much, because this is the same as doing something like, as we saw, we could do something like this. And this would be exactly the same. So this is useful, but not that useful. So class methods are so much more useful when it comes to alternative constructors. So basically now when we create a person, we need to do something like this. We need to do something like person one, person Jack, 14, London, like that. But what if we want to also be able to pass maybe a list with these values? We can't do something like this. We can't do something like person data, like a list, like John 45, New York, like that. And then do person two, person, and pass the person data like that. Of course, this would throw an error, okay? Type error, person in missing two required positional arguments, because actually you're passing just one argument and you've got three. And of course, Python doesn't know that you've got a list, etc., etc. So to make this work, we can actually create a new constructor using the class method so that you can use it when you need it. But before we go ahead, like the video if you're enjoying it and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish the next video of the series. And also leave a comment down below as well. I really appreciate it. So let's say that we have a new class method here, like this, and we do something like from list, then CLS, because this is a class method, and list data, something like that, okay? So here we've just created a new class method that takes a list as argument. Then I'm going to unpack it like this to get the data. And as we have the class itself as the first argument, so we've got CLS, we can create a new instance like this. So we can do something like CLS, name, age, city. And of course, we can return it. So we can save it to a variable and use that instance. Okay, so basically here we are creating an instance using a CLS, which is the same as doing something like this. Okay, this is the same. Perfect. So let's say that you don't have a list, you do something like this. But let's say that you actually have a list, like in this case. Instead of using person, person data like that, you can use something like person.fromList and then person data like that. Then we can print person1.name and print person2.name. So let's see if we get the same error or not. As you can see now, that works. So John, John, Jack, Jack. So now you've got two constructors, the default one with the init method and the alternative one, which is from list, which is really, really cool. Then we also have static methods, which are basically normal functions that are written as part of the class because it actually makes sense to have them there and not elsewhere. Let's say that we have a function to check if someone is older than 30. We could have a normal function like this. We could have something like, let's actually do that. We could have something like check age. So this is a normal function. This is not a method. Return age 30. But as this is related to a person, we can add it to the class like this. We can do something like static method, and we can do something like like this, static method. And this is just a simple function. It doesn't receive any implicit arguments. So the CLS, the self, etc., you don't get any of that. So we cannot change instance variable, class variables, etc. As I said, this is just a normal function and you can use it like this. You can use it like, you can do something like person.checkAge 40, something like that. And then you would get true or false, etc., etc. So as this is something sort of related to people, person, objects, etc., we decided to put it in here. It's basically just a way of structuring things and keep related things together instead of having them in a separated Python file. Okay, it wouldn't make sense to have this in another file and then having to import the file, etc. This is also used in modules for functions that can be called without creating an instance of the class. So let's say that we have a module like, I don't know, something like my module, like that, with a class in it. And we use a function like my module, I don't know, convert something, you know, something like that. You are not creating a my module instance. You're just using the convert function, which is a static method in the my module class, which is then also a module. And then you convert something. I hope that makes sense. So in the next video of this series, you're going to learn about special methods, also called Dunder or magic methods, which is something you definitely need to know. If the video is already out, you should see it on the screen along with the playlist containing all the videos of this series. And don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe for more videos like this. And I'll see you soon. Bye.